testing your infrastructure is a foundational element that supports your quality, your compliance, your efficiency, but also security and even your customer satisfaction. And to summarize it, your competitive edge. However, what we see at organizations is they often encounter challenges that affect all these critical business aspects. And the key question is then, how can automation help? It's great to have Anil Kollipara here. He's the Vice President of Product Management at Spirent Communication. And he's here to discuss the key challenges, but also all the innovations in testing automation. Welcome, Anil.
Thanks, Ronald. Thanks for inviting me. I'm glad to be here. Looking forward to the conversation.
Anil, can you explain in more detail how the growing complexity of the modern networks that we see, the modern technologies, have increased both the need for lab and test automation?
That's a great topic to discuss today. And before getting to the bottom of this, we need to understand where this complexity is coming from and how the enterprises are taking on more and more, digital transformation initiatives, and including AI. And this necessitates the need to scale their networks. And these enterprises are using a software-centric approach to scaling their networks. That includes, you know, the technologies like SDN, virtualization, cloudification, and so on. What happens when you do when you take this software-centric approach is that you have more number of elements in the network, more number of vendors, more number of layers. This results in a lot of moving parts, and these moving parts are, updating or upgrading at a much faster rate. This creates a compounding complexity, and we have done a detailed analysis around that, and we concluded that the new age networks are getting 100x to 150x more complex than the legacy networks. And this increased complexity results in the fact that customers or enterprises have to test more things more frequently, and throwing manual approaches by just physical bodies at it, it's not scalable. It's not scalable from both from a test coverage perspective as well as from a cost perspective. And that is the main challenge, and it leads to certain issues or challenges.
I want to dive a little bit deeper into the challenges. So what primary challenges in both lab and test environments can automation address? And can you share more about how this affects your productivity?
Yeah, we talked about the complexity as the root cause of all these challenges. And if you want to dive into the details of what these challenges are, number one being the increasing complexity necessitates the fact that you need to have an increased test coverage, and a lack of test coverage can result in outages, as you know, and outages are very costly. They're not only penalties associated with it, but also it impacts your customers. So that's number one. The second thing is regulations. Enterprises have to be compliant with many regulations, and lack of proper test coverage can result in incompliance with regulations, and again that leads to potential penalties and fines. And typically enterprises throw bodies at solving this problem by adding more and more manual effort in running these test cases or completing the testing. And that, as you know, is not scalable, both from a test coverage perspective, but also from a cost effectiveness perspective. So this results in an increased OPEX costs from a human resourcing perspective, also results in increased OPEX costs from inefficiencies in the network, as well as the associated power costs.
you're addressing the costs, the regulations as well. We see more challenges from silos, from narrow testing scope, but also the long processes it takes, or even you see duplicate efforts. So can you explain in more detail how you typically help your clients with these type of challenges and what kind of impact and improvements do you make?
So, in the end, the only way to get a handle of these kinds of challenges that the enterprises have is through a complete lab transformation or automation approach, wherein you're taking all your labs or your networks and connecting them to give you a very comprehensive coverage or access to your lab resources, the CapEx investment that you've made. And then layering that with lab automation as well as test automation that allows you to run testing continuously, in the sense that when any change to any part of the network happens, this could be a software upgrade to any of the network elements, it could be a security patch, it could be anything, that kicks off a complete test cycle in an automated fashion. And you get the test results. This approach ensures that all kinds of changes, and we talked about the number of changes that are happening in the network, all of those are completely tested and comprehensively tested and documented for regulatory reasons. And this will ensure that you're compliant to regulations. This will ensure that your test coverage is completely solid, and it, your chance of having outages in the production network are minimized or eliminated. And it helps you achieve your business goals, wherein your app business applications, whether there are trading applications, whether there are banking applications, run smoothly without impacting the end subscriber or end customer.
Yeah, and this 100x times the complexity, I can imagine that with the number of changes you make continuously to your networks, and that really desires and requires a continuous testing instead of this testing when go live, it's not applicable anymore. Now, Anil, thanks a lot for your great insights in how test and lab automation can really make a difference for organizations, both for their cost, but also, of course, for all the aspects that are important for their competitive edge. And to our audience, thank you for watching, and we look forward to seeing you next time.